and with hedging is a very, very important topic as far as exam is concerned. If you remember these 8-9 points, there is no, this topic becomes very, very easy. If you are unable to remember these 8-9 lines, very difficult. This milk and milk hygiene. Milk, everybody knows, human milk, buffalo milk, cow milk. Next topic is milk hygiene. Milk hygiene means, hygiene means cleanliness. Milk should be free from the bacteria, viruses, protozoa, etc. Milk which is free from all these organisms is called as safe milk for drinking. Or you can consume that milk without any getting any infection. So, in introduction of milk, milk means, I am talking about the human milk, breast milk. Human milk is a, this milk is secreted by a mother for its, for his offspring, means for the children. Milk is secreted by a breast of a mother for their little one or a child. By and large, this milk is called as complete food, as far as the small kid is considered. Because why this is called as complete food? Because this milk contains carbohydrate, protein, fats, mineral, vitamins. God gift. Free of cost. No money is required for this. Only love is required between mother and its child or offspring, what we call. So coming to one by one, protein. Mother milk contains all essential proteins. It contains tryptophan, threonine, albumins, lactoglobulin, and lactoglobulin. So all these are essential and non-essential amino acids. Amino acid is the basic molecule of any protein. It contains all these essential and non-essential molecules which are required for the growth of the baby. Remember, proteins are never stored in your body. Their degradation occurs daily. If you consume 100 grams of protein today, till tomorrow morning, 100% degradation occurs. No storage. Next is the fat. So milk, every milk, human milk, buffalo milk, cow milk contains fat. Human milk contains 3.3 grams of fat, while buffalo milk contains 8.8 grams of fat. So it is almost one third of the animal fat present in the human milk. So whenever you are giving animal milk, like cow milk or buffalo milk, at least time double the, if you are you are taking 50 ml of the animal milk, then at least you must dilute it by double. So 50 ml milk, 100 ml water. Then only that milk can be consumed safely by the small kid. Otherwise, that as the animal milk contains lot of fat, baby will get diarrhea. So this is about the fat. Now the carbohydrate, same. It contains, human milk contains carbohydrate. It contains minerals and vitamins. All minerals, calcium, potassium, then sodium, magnesium, all these are present in the human milk. And the vitamins, all vitamins are present. Right from vitamin A, it is rich of, human milk is rich of vitamin A, vitamin D. Only thing is, mother has to be healthy. Mother should not suffer from the vitamin A deficiency or vitamin D deficiency. So mother, human milk contains retinol, vitamin A, vitamin D. Then all B complex from B1 to B6, A, D, E, K, all these vitamins are present in the human milk. Except only one vitamin is absent in the human milk. That is vitamin C. Vitamin C. Because vitamin C has got a bitter taste. We cannot consume that milk which contains the vitamin C. So God has made human body like this. Sab de diya vitamin C nahi de. Because it cannot consume that milk. If suppose mother milk contains vitamin C, child will not consume. So everything is there. All vitamins are there except vitamin C. This is our same body. Now, there are different types of milk, different milk kind its products we consume. Like we consume whole milk, we consume curd, we consume skimmed milk, we consume the packaged milk, we consume the ghee, we consume the toned milk. Toned milk means what? Toned milk means one part of water, one part of steamed milk, and one part of whole milk, pure milk. This is called as toned milk, which comes in the form of packing. So from where we get the milk infection? There are two possibilities from where the milk can become infected. Number one is man-to-man infection. Means if the mother is suffering from diseases like tuberculosis, brucellosis, fungal infection, any viral infection, then automatically as milk is secreted by the breast of the mother, that breast becomes infected and the milk is likely to get infected. This is man to man, mother to child infection. Man to animal or animal to man, vice versa. If an animal is suffering from tuberculosis, brucellosis, fungal infection, streptococcus and staphylococcal infection, then automatically the milk will become infected. If the animal is kept in an unsterile area where day-to-day cleaning is not applicated, then that area becomes infected. That's why our farmers, they daily clean the area where the animals are kept. They daily give the bath to the animals which is giving the milk. So, second type of infection from where the milk can become infected is animal to man. Commonest type of infection what we get? We get the infection of tuberculosis, brucellosis, streptococcal, staphylococcal, shigellosis, typhoid, bacilli can infect. The person may get the typhoid, the paratyphoid fever. So, these are the two. So, before milking, the animal has to be cleaned properly. Hands of the person who is going to milk the milk, he should wash the hand properly. The vessel in which the milk has to be milked, that vessel has to be sterile. Must have the proper coverage. So these are the few things so that milk can remain safe for consumption. Now coming to, there is one test called as methylene blue test to test the whether the milk has been defected or not. What is this test? You take 1 ml of methylene blue reagent, add to that 1 ml of the milk and allow to stand for 2 minutes. Longer the methylene blue is a blue color. Longer the duration of blue color of the milk means milk is free from infection. Shorter the duration means milk is infected. So this is a very simple test. Now pasteurization of milk. Pasteurization of milk is nothing but it is sterilization, ways of sterilization of the milk. Sterilization means there should not be any infective thing, living or non-living, in the milk. So this method is given by Louis Pasteur. That's why it's called as pasteurization. This you have heard many times, but I will actually give the what is meant by pasteurization. Concentrate for only 3 minutes. Very simple. If you cannot concentrate, you read 100 times, you will not understand it. So pasteurized milk is a process in which milk is made sterilized for consumption purpose. Very simple. Given by Louis Pasteur. There are 3 methods. Colder vat method. Yet high temperature, short time method, and HST method. Basic thing on which all these 3 tests are based on, number one is duration of heating. This is the basic one. And second thing is how much time is given for cooling of that meat. On only these 2 processes, on is only 2 principles, temperature and duration of cooling down. On these 2 principles, all these 3 tests are based. So in Holder vat method, milk is heated up to 63 to 66 degree temperature, and it is suddenly cooled up down to 4 degree temperature within 15 minutes. This is the Holder vat. This method is used for sterilization or pasteurization milk on small scale. So small quantity of milk can be pasteurized by Holder vat method. High temperature, short time, HTST method. In this method, milk is heated up to 72 degree temperature and it is suddenly cooled down to 4 degree temperature within 5 minutes. That is called as HT, high temperature, short time. This method is used for milk, pasteurized milk on large basis. Whatever the method is carried out in milk dairy, is HTST method. Third is HST method. In this, milk is heated up to 123 degree centigrade and within second it is cooled down. But this is not used in practice. What is used in practice is high temperature, short time method. High temperature, short time method is used regularly in practice, day-to-day practice. Now you have pasteurized the milk. What are the tests, whether the milk has been pasteurized or not? There are 3 tests. First test is phosphatase test, uniform test, and bacterial test. What is phosphatase test? The phosphatase enzyme is naturally present into the milk. The phosphatase enzyme is naturally present into the milk. When you heat the milk, this phosphatase enzyme is destroyed. So test the milk for presence of phosphatase enzyme. If it is present, means milk is not pasteurized. It has to be absent. So absence of phosphatase enzyme means milk is pasteurized. Second is coliform test. Coliform test means milk contains microorganisms. Coliform organism. Milk contains coliform organism. So even after pasteurization, if the organisms are present into the milk, so there is a certain level of microorganisms. If they are present in 1 ml of the milk, if the 30,000 bacilli or the microorganisms are present per 1 ml of the milk, that is accepted. If it is more than that, you cannot consume. Third test is bacterial test. What this third test says, there should not be present of any bacteria in the dashla. So, presence of coliform organism up to 30,000 per 1 ml of the meat is accepted. But in bacterial test, the standard of bacterial test is not a single bacteria has to be present into the pasteurized meat. If a single bacteria is there in a bacterial test means milk is not pasteurized. So this is about the pasteurization. Be prepared for this because the question is invariably, repeatedly asked in the examination.